Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're talking DE filters. It's springtime, and it's the time of year when everybody likes to get the pool cleaned up, and usually it's a good time to clean the filter. We recommend cleaning it at least once a year, and we prefer to do that in the spring, especially after all the pollen is down. So your pressure gauge on your tank normally will run anywhere from 15 to 25 pounds, and then when it's dirty, it may run 20 to 30, 35, and you know it's time to clean the filter when you just can't get that pressure to come down. It stays high, you backwash, recharge it, and then one day it's high again. Then you know it's time to clean it. So it's simple, turn everything off so that there's no power. Once the pump is off, there's no pressure on the tank. You can loosen the air relief. Yours may have a different style, but this Pentair, when you just twist it, and it will release the there's no pressure on it if the pump is off, but it'll be filled with water, so there's vacuum pressure. So we want to release that vacuum seal. Once you open it, you'll hear it hiss as all the water is draining back out of the filter. So once it stops making noise, loosen the nut that holds the tension spring. Take it loose, pair of pliers. Once you get the top off of the tank, pull the lid up and set it aside, and then you're going to be left with this. This will be inside of the filter, and the way you get it out, there's two handles. It says lift here. You're going to pick up and twist and pull. Now keep in mind, it's very heavy. If it's full of DE, it may weigh upwards of 100 pounds. If it's so heavy you can't get it out, loosen the nuts on top. Once you get it loose, then just kind of work it back and forth and pick up on it. And you want to be careful you don't break the valve guides where they go into the top of the manifold. So this is what they call the manifold. All the water comes in through this and works its way back to the pool. So you can see this one really needs to be cleaned. Look at all the gunk inside of there. Just loads and loads of, now a lot of this is DE powder, but the DE powder collects all of the dirt, and you can see the grass and bugs, who knows what's in there, but and mud. This is what your filter collects and keeps it out of the pool. So once a year we pull that apart and clean it. So we get it apart. Best thing to do is just lay these out in the grass. Use your water hose with a spray nozzle on it. Spray them off so that they're nice and clean. You look for any holes in them. If they got holes in them, just replace them. Don't try to patch it. And this one, you can see there's a couple of places where the fabric is worn, the plastic is poking through, and that just makes a hole. As you can see here, there's a hole in it, different places, but it tells you that it's time to replace it. Got one here and there. Also found one on this one. Had the fabric poking through on the corner. If you can see that, you can see where it's just a little hole worn in the corner. The corners are common places, and then in the spine, the DE is very fine, so any hole will allow that to pass back through the pool. So you don't want any holes in the fabric at all, so that all the DE stays inside the filter, because the DE powder is what actually filters the water. So we want to fix that. So go ahead and get that, get your garden hose out and clean your grids, and I'll show you how to put it together. Okay, now that you've got it cleaned or replaced, whatever you're gonna do, the tricky part comes, putting it back together. You're gonna notice there's 7 of them that are all the same size, and you have one that is smaller. So one of them is smaller, and the reason that one is smaller is inside of your filter, the standpipe is there, and that standpipe fits in that slot. So the short one is going to go right there, and it's only short to allow for this pipe, so kind of gives you a clue where it goes. Okay, so let's put this back together. And the trick is, if you'll notice, these grids are kind of a crescent shaped, kind of C-shaped, and if you look at your manifold now, 90% of them are this way. They actually have some sort of pattern in the bottom, and you'll notice that's the same shape as your grid. So you can start with the small one. Now this is the Pentair filter. We have a lot of these out there. And this one actually tells you small grid. If yours doesn't have it marked, just remember it goes where the cutout is for the pipe. And we'll start on the first row and about an inch past it, you'll drop it in and then it'll just come into place. And if you'll notice, this is the trick. At every juncture, every intersection, you want to step in one point. So this one, it starts on the second rung. So at the next intersection, we want to be on the third one. And then at the next intersection, we're going to be on the fourth one. And if you'll do all of them like that, they'll pop very easily into place. So we'll go to number two. This one, we'll start it at the edge. We'll go about 1 inch past it. And at every intersection, we'll step in one level. So we're going to start at the end, about an inch past it. We're on number one here. We're on number two here. We're on three and four. And we'll just continue that until we get them all in. And once you get the first one in place, the rest of them really just kind of fall into place. Just start at the corner, step in about an inch on every one. We should be able to do this in just a minute or two. The other trick is to get a very flat spot. I'm on the patio here, good and flat. Okay, once they're all in place, get your manifold, and then remember, this part goes where the pipe sticks up. Now, this pipe has been removed, but it's normally inside the filter, along the edge of the filter. This is an old one that broke. I'm just using it to show you. But where that pipe sticks up is where this is going to go. So we're going to start there, align our two rods. This probably is the trickiest part, getting the rods lined up. And if you got an extra set of hands, that'll help too. But just slowly work the ends of the filters back into the manifold. It's a little tedious. Now don't pound on it because that'll break them. And I just kind of push and wiggle. There they go. They begin to drop in. One more tip. Once you get one corner in, pull the rod up and put a nut on it. And that kind of holds that in place. Then you can slowly work your rest of the way around it. And you'll see now the newer filters have a guide, a little plastic guide that goes on top, and it holds your rods in place, so it's a little easier. Okay, once the rods are secured, now we're just going to slowly work these down into position. And I think we've got them all in. Okay, once they're all in, tighten up the rods. Okay, you're going to tighten, and then you want to push and twist. And you can see right now all of the elements, the grids, are really loose and floppy, flimsy. So just keep tightening. Usually I'll tighten them, I'll snug them. And I'll push, and I'll snug them. Okay, and once you get it good and tight, you'll notice that when I'm twisting, these grids don't move around anymore. Okay, then you just pick the whole assembly back up and set it down into the tank. Put the lid on it, tighten it up, and you're back in business. Be sure to recharge it with plenty of DE according to what size your filter is, and hope that helps.